Hi everyone and welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to be mixing a little business with pleasure. How's that? Many of you might know already that I run and own a little luxury niche handbag brand, which means I design and craft luxury leather goods here in Germany. I do bespoke work and individual work, and today I wanted to share some of my leather working knowledge with you in telling you how to see all of the little details and how to tell if the bag you want to buy is a high quality bag or not. So let's get right into the video, and I'm going to share all of the details with you today. I will show you examples of what I'm talking about with some of the luxury bags that I own, with some examples coming from my own line. So just for you to see what exactly you should be looking at when you're in the store trying to decide whether or not to invest in this specific bag that you're looking at. The first thing I want to talk about is hardware, and I'm going to show you two examples, one good, one not so good example, on high quality or seemingly high quality hardware on a bag. And first I want to show you one of the first high quality bags that I have ever bought, and it's this one. It's from Marc Jacobs. I think it's called Lil Q or something. And I really like that the hardware is all black and the bag itself is a really sturdy bag. I really, really loved wearing this all the time. I took it to work. It also has a crossbody strap, so it's a very practical bag. But what I didn't think of when buying this bag is that the black hardware is wearing off very, like, badly. So you can see what I'm talking about. The hardware is, like, the black is wearing off pretty badly. Also here on the sides of the bag, this is something to keep in mind when buying such bags. So this is not that the bag is bad quality, but this is not long wearing hardware because of the matte black finish. This is some kind of rubberized finish, and it doesn't wear very well. So take a really good look at the hardware. If it has, like, some kind of finish on top of it, you have to keep in mind it doesn't wear very well. So what does good hardware look like? I'm going to show you with my, believe it or not, 1981 vintage Louis Vuitton Noe bag. And I just wanted to show you that, like, the hardware they're using here, as you can see here, so the hardware on this bag looks really good still. It's almost 40 years old. You can tell the leather did wear very well also. So this is a very high quality piece of hardware. I do have another example with new hardware, and this is my black Gucci waist belt bag. And here I just wanted to show you, I don't know if you can see, like, how well made this little snap thingy is, the snap closure. You can also, like, try and open and close the hardware. Like, give it a really good try. Look at it closely. Does it look cheap? Does it look sturdy? Does it look well made? So finding really good hardware is, I can tell you from my very own experience running my own brand, this is one of the hardest things. So finding a supplier that provides you with high quality, long lasting, beautiful hardware is very, very difficult. And some of these brands really look into it and have really nice hardware. And some of the things to look at are also, like, what type of finish does the hardware have? So if you invest in a luxury handbag, you want the hardware to look really nice and to age very well. And this is, for example, why the brass hardware on the Louis Vuitton bag is wearing so nicely, because it's brass, and brass ages well. Also silver, if it's in or silver hardware, it tends to age a little better than the gold one, because sometimes the gold one is just pleated and then that wears off. So have a really good look at the hardware of the bag. How does it feel? Is it very heavy? I know there are some brands out there like Liebeskind Berlin, for example. They tend to use pretty heavy hardware and I detest that. That's just my own taste. So I don't want the bag to be even more heavy when it comes to the hardware. Another detail to look at when it comes to buying a luxury handbag, and I know this is some type of hardware, but I think it deserves a special mentioning, and this is zippers. You have to take a look at the zipper of the bag. So does it run smoothly? That's like the first indicator. Does it open smoothly? Does it close smoothly? How do you feel about it? Is it like stuck somewhere? How is the zipper like placed? All of these things, because mastering the art of zippers is one of the like most difficult things when it comes to leather craft. Also, buying high quality zippers is expensive as hell. So I'm buying my zippers from a brand called Riri Meyer. They are from Switzerland. It's an old family run business there. Their zippers are like top notch. I know some brands use them too. Most common is the brand YKK. We all know zippers from YKK. They are also of good quality, but they have different like ranges. So some of the zippers that they offer are better, some are not so good. So take a look at the zipper, because zippers can be the thing to break first. So if you're looking for a bag, for example, with a top zipper, and when you're in the store, the zipper seems to not run very smoothly, or you feel like something is not quite well made with the zipper, then don't buy the bag, because this will be the thing to break at first. And also, zippers are very difficult to replace in a leather bag or to repair. It's not the easiest thing to do. So look out for the zipper. Pay attention to that one too. The next detail to look at is the leather. And I chose this Marc Jacobs bag because it has such a nice leather. It's very soft. It has a great structure. It's very like, it looks very enduring. It can take a lot. You can just wipe it with a wet like cotton cloth if you spill something on top of it. So you really want to look for the leather of your bag. I mean, if it's suede and you are somebody who is like really careful with all of this stuff, you can definitely go for suede. But if you're looking for an investment piece that wears well over time and that doesn't like look really dirty really quickly, then go for like a Nappa leather that is easy to clean and to take care of and that will last you a very long time. Also, this bag costs about, I think, $400, and it is lined with fabric, and the fabric is a pretty cheap nylon fabric. But for this type of bag, it's okay, because it's like, it's supposed to be really slouchy and soft. And with this type of bag, it's really difficult to produce with a leather lining. But when we are going up in the price range, looking at some of the of the really expensive brands, like for example Gucci, Chanel, you name it, then, or my Chloe bag. I talked about my Chloe Phi bag in another video before. I bought that one because I thought it was very timeless, but then I ended up selling it. But all of these bags tend to be lined with leather too. So that is an indicator of quality too. Because, you know, leather is just more expensive than fabric, and also it's just that the luxury leather work tends to be more wholesome when it comes to using as much leather and different types of leather as possible in a bag. So now I'm going to show you with one of my designs. This is the Julie bag with the logo guitar handle strap. And my designs are mostly lined with leather too. As you can see, the whole bag is lined with leather. I only do fabric lining if it has to do with some structural issues or design that I want it to be like especially slouchy and soft. Then I also opt for like a thicker linen or cotton lining. I don't like to use nylon or like any kind of plastic fabric, so that's just my personal taste. But you can also check that out when buying an expensive or when buying any handbag. If you see it being lined with leather, that's also one indicator of the quality of the bag. The next detail I want to show you and talk about is the stitching. And I'm taking the Julie bag for that one too, because on this one I used contrast stitching, so it's easier for you to see. All of my products are hand stitched, and this is why you can see the angled stitch on this one. But just look for like how even are the stitches, how well is it threaded. Do you see anything like that's off-putting or not centered or something like that? Most of the luxury labels don't do the excessive work and like intense hours of hand stitching anymore, so there are just a few. Most of you, of course, everybody knows MS with the Birkin bag, and this is one of the most popular brands known for using all of the old and ancient methods of leather crafting and leather work, and this includes hand stitching or saddle stitching. This is just because you know, the seams are different. So when you're doing a traditional saddle stitch, the thread does interlock at each and every stitch. So what you're basically doing is you're creating a knot with every stitch, and this is why the stitches or the hand stitched seams are so much more durable, and this is also why you can repair them way easier. If you think about any garment that you have and the seam gets loose at one place, and then you start like pulling on the seam and like the whole seam just rips apart, and this can't happen with the saddle stitched items. So this is why I'm using this ancient method of hand stitching, which takes up so much time. For example, just for the creation of a shoulder strap like this one, the stitching time when saddle stitching is about 2 hours, and you can imagine when doing it by machine it would be about 2 minutes. So this is also something to keep in mind when buying a luxury bag. But also, it's only done by a few like high fashion, like luxury handbag brands. But keep in mind that most of the luxury handbags out there are not saddle stitched. So this is not a bad thing per se, but just look at the seams, look at the details, look at the placement of the seam. Is everything like at least 80% like nice and clean, and then you're good. So the next thing to look at is the edges of your bag or leather item. And I'm talking about this thing over here, and this is called edge paint. So look at the finishing of the edges of your bag. And for my leather goods, I use about 3 to 5 layers of edge paint on each item. Each layer has to dry for at least 30 minutes, so we are getting here again. It's a matter of time. And also, I feel like this is where some of the companies try to save time and therefore money again. Look at how evenly the edge paint is applied, and also look at like if there's any like spillage here, if the person who did the edge painting made a mess when applying the paint and didn't bother to clean it up. When I first bought a more or less expensive handbag that cost, I think, about 300 euros, it was from Hugo Boss and I really liked it. It was this burgundy colored bowling bag, but one of the first things to fail me in the bag was the edge paint. And it was the edge paint on the handle, like on this one here, because when you grab the bag like that all the time, which I did because it was a bowling bag, you know, you carry it in your hand just like that, the sweat of your hands gets on the handle, and this can lead to some nice aging, like on my Louis Vuitton Neu bag. This one aged really well, but with the Hugo Boss bag that I owned, like the edge paint, it just came off and then it looked awful. Now I know how to repair it and I know that it can be repaired. Like it's not a big deal. So if you have a bag where the edge paint did come off, because this can have many reasons, but mostly it's because there aren't enough like layers of the edge paint, or like the paint didn't like sink into the leather really well. So this can be repaired, so find the leather worker of your trust, and there are so many out there. There's like these handbag clinics that like restore your luxury bags and all of that, so it can be repaired. But just look out for how well the edge paint is applied, and I have used this Marc by Marc Jacobs bag a ton, and the edge paint like here on this handle, it just did not move. So look at that, it's very evenly applied, it's a thick layer, and you're good with a very well edge painted bag, because the edge paint actually protects the leather from rain, it protects the leather like from tear and wear and all of that. So the process of edge painting is also very time consuming, and that's why many of the bags that are on the cheaper side do only have one or two layers of edge paint. Cheap edge paint also, you know, like with the hardware, the edge paint can also like be, it's basically the same thing. So the quality of the edge paint does matter as well, but you can't tell the quality of the edge paint by just looking at it, but you can look at how well the edges are worked, how well the paint is applied, and this is another detail to look at when buying an expensive handbag. My final advice for you is to really have a look at the design, at the practicality, and at the wear that you will be getting out of the bag. And that's just talking from my experience with the Chloe Fay bag, which I thought I would wear a ton, I would use so much, but then my situation changed, I changed jobs, I started my own business, and then I didn't have to go to the office every day anymore, and then I didn't get a lot of use out of a very expensive bag. I mean, the bag costs 1500 euros, so it's not a cheap bag at all. And then I realized after a year or a year and a half that I had worn the bag 10 times tops. So really think about, how do I use the bags that I already own? Am I a crossbody girl? Am I an over-the-shoulder person? Do I prefer if my bag has a top handle so that I can carry it with my hand or on the elbow? Really think about how you are using the bag, and what's your favorite bag that you already have, and what you don't like about that bag, and what you would like to like have improved on that particular bag that you love already. So I really feel that when investing in a luxury or high quality handbag, you should really think about all of these factors. And this is also why I decided to start my own brand, because I always found something irritating about a bag, or I didn't like the exact color, I didn't like the color of the hardware, I didn't like the size, I felt that it was missing a crossbody strap or anything like that. And this is why I decided to like have a bespoke business where I design everything just for the individual client, the length of the strap, the design of the straps and all of that. But if you're not interested in going with a niche brand or a small designer that offers all of these services as I do, and if you are looking to buy that, I don't know, maybe that current very it bag, or maybe it's your Chanel investment bag that you've been dreaming of like 4 years, really think about what design will bring you the most use and what you will wear like the most, and then try and then go and have fun and buying the bag and invest in that really cool piece, and that will elevate all of your outfits, because it's just, it makes you feel great, it makes you feel like more sophisticated, and it makes you happy wearing that bag. This is it, everybody. I really hope I could share some of my knowledge with you today on what to look for when buying an investment handbag, what the details are that matter, and how you can tell if a bag is really a high quality item or not. Thank you so much for watching today's video. My name is Aline. I would love for you to join the family and subscribe to my channel, ring the bell, all of that. I post about makeup, lifestyle, and my brand, Aline Zyla, which is named after me. I really hope you enjoyed me sharing my knowledge on leatherwork with you today. Have an amazing day, and I hope to see you soon on my channel. Bye!